Logic and science, two things that we as humans have studied for centuries. And logic and science is great and all, but like, what about absolute nonsense? These two characters thrive on that. They have a thirst that can never be fully quenched. Genie, Disney's joke-cracking magician, versus the mask, the smoking tune. Today, these two OP pop culture referencing beings are going to fight each other. But which one will win in a ranting royale? We'll figure this out today as we go into our first opponent, the Genie.
Disney's had a lot of magical creatures over the years. They had goblins, wizards, witches, and even skeleton people, but none of them come close to Disney Aladdin's Genie. Genie's origins are very unknown. We don't know where he really came from. All we know is that he comes from a lamp, and he helped Aladdin defeat Jafar as well. However, we can go up from there, and now let's get to Genie's feats. First off, Genie should be comparable to Jafar in his Mega Genie form, who is around solar system level. Genie can also scale to this goblin guy, who blew up into 3 stars upon his defeat, making Genie easily around solar system this large star level in power. He can also casually put planets on his hand and spin them around like it's nothing. And from scaling to Jafar again, he reaches massively faster than light speeds since he's on par with Genie Jafar, who grew out into space in just a matter of seconds. In terms of durability, Genie is kind of complicated. You see, he has high levels of regeneration and Toon Force durability, but the only real way to kill Genie is if you destroy his lamp. So if you don't destroy the lamp, he's still alive, or if you do destroy the lamp, he's gone. Now, let's get to what you've all been waiting for, Genie's abilities. Genie can duplicate himself. He has transmutation abilities. He can teleport people. He has telekinesis. He can teleport himself. He has Toon Force regeneration. He can break the fourth wall. He has lightning manipulation, and he can grow in size as well. Man, Genie has a lot of insane abilities, but it comes at one big cost, but I'll get to that later. While Genie has shown to be very, very intelligent, he has shown to be pretty naive at times, and hasn't shown to be the smartest person around. However, that leads into Genie's weaknesses. Genie is quite naive, to say the least. And also, from what I mentioned earlier, the lamp thing, yeah, if Genie's lamp is destroyed, he's gone, it's over. And Genie's abilities cannot harm or affect humans as well, meaning he cannot kill anyone or wish for anyone to be killed. So those are two major flaws in Genie. However, that doesn't stop Genie from being one of Disney's hugest powerhouses. Can he defeat the mask? Let's see.
Hello everybody, welcome to my part of the bit. I know, this is kind of wonky. Anyways, I'm here to talk about the mask, and let's just get right into it. Stanley Ickes, right? He's this guy, his life is not very good. He got his car broken down. Or just kicking it. That's really sad. F'n chat, boys. Anyways, everything was going terrible and normal as, until one day. He saw someone drowning in the water, so he came in to save him, but it actually wasn't someone drowning. It was just garbage, but it wasn't any other garbage. It was my YouTube channel, Random Stunkle! Oh my god! Just kidding, it was actually on his mask he found, but he was like, you know what, I'm gonna take this home. You know, I think this would be really cool. So he took it home, and he's like, you know what, I'm gonna wear it. And then he became the mask, boom! Now you may be wondering, oh hey, how is this mask created? Well, nobody knows. Some say it was created by Loki, not that Loki, this Loki from this terrible movie, actually. Some say it was created by some voodoo ritual thingy. I don't know. And also they say it's created by gods, but no one really knows. Alright, so the first thing I'm going to talk about is the mask's strengths. Now, the mask can lift cartoonishly heavy objects. Now, if you were to think about it, that's actually quite a lot. It can also easily destroy large buildings with one shove. Wow. They can also easily bust through things such as bricks or iron. They can cause destruction that has made a planet move and cause earthquakes. And he's also fought opponents that easily destroy concrete and bricks, as well as buildings and even towns. Now it's time to talk about his speeds. Now the mask is very fast. He's even faster than the speed of light. How did I get this, of course? Well, he's even dodged a lightning bolt. Like, faster than lightning. In his tornado form, he could easily flash around buildings. He can also dodge lightning, lasers, and gunfire. Yeah, that's crazy. Arguably his most impressive speed feature is when he ran around the Earth in seconds, which is also kind of like the speed of lightning. Alright, now it's time to talk about regeneration and durability. Anyways, he can survive gunfire, being caught on fire, electrocution, hurting himself, being squashed and stretched, and vaporized and turning to ash. Basically, the mask can survive anything and everything. And talking about his durability is basically useless. Mask is also alive and gives its user what they desire. The mask powers also revolve on the user's imagination. The mask has many powers, such as shape-shifting, grabbing weapons out of nowhere, reality warping, time traveling, regeneration, multiplication, limb removal, stretching limbs, toon force, flying, and incredible speed. He could fight on par with Lobo, which basically makes him somewhere around star level. He also has fighting experience, can breathe in space, and he also has fourth wall awareness. Something else he has is flexibility and acrobatics, and he can run around cities in seconds. The mask, although is clever, sometimes is usually insane and not mentally put together. It's just a total whack job. And there is still some part of the user's mind in the mask, so if you can convince the user to take the mask off, it will happen. There's also an inconsistency of the mask coming off at morning time. The reason this is because the mask has sometimes been seen in the morning with fighting monsters and villains. But despite those weaknesses, the mask is one tomb you do not want to mess with. But can he defeat Will Smith? No, wait. But can he defeat Will Smith? Genie. Let's see.
Now you have to ask yourself one question. Do I feel lucky? Well, do ya, punks?
Alrighty then, now that the characters have been researched, which magic men will win this debate? We'll figure this out today. This is Ranting Royale. Stanley Ipkiss was taking a nice little stroll around the park. He had purchased ice cream, but before he could lick it, he accidentally tripped on his own shoe nails, and the ice cream dropped. Poor Ipkiss. However, he dropped the ice cream because he noticed a loud sound. He went to see what that giant poof sound was, and then he saw the genie and Aladdin. Aladdin then yelled at the genie for sending them to the wrong place, but then genie apologized and started joking around of how crazy this place looked compared to each of times that they lived in. Ipkiss then noticed this and mistaked them for bad guys. So he immediately took out the one and only mask, putting it on. Aladdin and genie, joking around, then noticed a tornado coming out of a bush. Then a hat flew on Genie. However, an arm quickly grabbed that hat. It was the mask. The genie and the mask were standing next to each other, face to face. But before anyone could say anything, the mask hit Genie with a boxing glove. The genie, realizing what was going on here, tried to get the mask to realize that he wasn't a villain. However, the mask wouldn't listen. This is surely going to be a toontastic battle.
Fight!
The mask then grabbed a knight sword out of nowhere, trying to zoom at the genie and ram the sword into his gut. However, the genie quickly teleported away, and then he got behind the mask and turned into a giant. He then zapped the mask with electricity. The mask was then zapped. He turned into ash, but then he quickly reverted back into his mask old fancy form. And then he grabbed Genie and slammed him with a mallet, turning him into a pancake. The mask then transformed into a chef and then cooked up the genie. However, the genie stood right behind the mask and then grabbed him, throwing him all the way up into the air, all the way up into space. They were both fighting in space, throwing stars at each other and throwing planets at each other. But then the genie grabbed the mask and rammed him through dozens of planets where they exploded. However, the mask was still alive, although he felt a little woozy. And then the genie started punching pizzazz in him. However, the mask got the upper edge. He twisted into his tornado, and then he turned into a giant, crushing the genie. The genie got knocked out, but then immediately got back up, cartoon fashion. But then they both brawled and brawled. Eventually, they decided to take the battle back into the park, where they then rammed into the park like a asteroid, blew up half of the city, and possibly killed many of innocent lives. Oh well. The genie and the mask were still squashing, stretching, and fighting around. However, the mask realized, why won't this guy be destroyed? Why won't he die? But then, the genie was thinking the same. But then, the mask realized what was happening. He saw the genie's lamp. Realizing what genies were, naturally, the mask grabbed the genie's lamp. The genie almost caught him with his telekinesis, but however, the mask was fast enough to grab the lamp. But then, the mask was about to smash the lamp. However, the genie fell down, accepting his fate. But then, the mask, looking at Genie, just tossed the Genie lamp away. He ran up to the Genie and said, hey, how about me and you go ball and get some pizza, you know? The Genie then agreed to this. And then, Aladdin, the Genie, and the mask went out to get pizza and ball. Happy ending. Yay. This battle was really close. These two were neck and neck with all their abilities, strength, power, hacks, intelligence, a lot. However, the mask gets one little edge and prevails. So let's explain. Yes, while the genie may be faster since he's somewhat MFTL in speed, that wouldn't exactly matter since probably wouldn't be able to speed blitz the mask with any of his abilities since the mask can't die either. However, the mask can one time get to the genie's lamp and destroy it. And as we all know, if the genie's lamp is destroyed, the genie is destroyed as well. And even if you want to argue the genie was freed from the lamp and can't be affected by the lamp, the mask would still be able to knock the genie out or put him in a state where he couldn't regenerate. Thanks to his big, big, masky, big brain cartoon Bugs Bunny powers. So it seems that the mask gets the slight edge. However, this was really close. The winner is the mask.
Somebody stop me! Listen! I'm not anyone. ordinary superhero. Not your everyday spandex wearing zero. Did someone say it's party